HiFly is a global airline with 19 aircraft, flying all around the world each day, and they have a revenue of over $1 billion. However, you won't be able to book a flight with them. How come, and what kind of airline is HiFly? Let's talk aviation. HiFly is a wet lease and charter airline. This means that they will operate flights for other airlines instead of under their own name. Later on in the video, I will give some nice examples, but first we have to understand their business model. As mentioned before, they operate on a business-to-business level. The airline offers two types of services, wet lease and charter flights. In the wet lease model, an airline might need some extra capacity fast, but for a relatively short period. In that case, they can contact HiFly, which will then provide the plane with the crew. The leasing airline will pay for the fuel, airport fees and other expenses directly, thus not via HiFly. Another service they provide is charter flights. While this may look a lot like the wet lease operations, there are some differences. Usually, the charter flights are known further in advance and the contacts will span longer periods. Another difference is the way the finances are handled. Where the leasing airline will pay for fuel bills directly with wet lease, in the charter case, they pay a flat fee to HiFly, who will then handle all expenses. It's almost like buying plane tickets in bulk, with the addition that you can set the schedule. This therefore is a great option for tour operators who will need some extra capacity during the peaks in the season. With the products of HiFly laid out, let's have a look at the airline itself. What is their history? And which planes do and did they operate? The airline, based in Portugal, was founded in 2005. Their goal was to become a wide-body wet lease airline. In 2006, they received their air operator certificate to operate flights in Europe. 1 year later, the airline kept growing at a steady pace as they added more A330s to their fleet. And next to this, they also got the certification to operate flights to North America. Fast forwarding some more years, at the beginning of the 2010s, they operated a couple of A330 and A340 aircraft. In 2013, they opened a subsidiary in Malta, HiFly Malta. And in the meantime, they moved a part of their fleet over there. Since the airline does not require hubs as ordinary airlines do, the reasons why HiFly expanded into Malta have little to do with the location of the islands in the Mediterranean. However, in their quest to attract more aviation businesses to the island, the government offered some nice incentives next to the already attractive fiscal legislation. The airline kept growing and became the largest in the business. To diversify their portfolio further, they announced that they would add the A380 to their fleet in 2017. The plane arrived a year later and it was painted in a rather nice livery, asking awareness for the coral reefs around the world. It would be phased out after 2 years of operations and is currently no longer in use. Besides their wide-body fleet, they also operate a number of smaller aircraft. They have two A319s, with place for 150 passengers, and two A321s with a capacity of 220 passengers, with an all-economy configuration. On the wide-body side, they operate 9 A330s, of which one NEO. The Dash-200 and Dash-300 are fitted with 250 to 300 seats, but the Dash-900 has 371, of which most economy. The last type they operate is the Airbus A340. They operate 6, and just like the A330s, they have just over 250 seats. As I mentioned before, they have used the A380 for 2 years. While they originally planned to operate two A380s, they only ever operated one. The plane they used wasn't new. It had been used by Singapore Airlines before, and after their 10-year lease expired, HiFly stepped in to lease the plane for initially 2 years, and after these, they opted not to renew the lease. While the pandemic certainly made the decision easier, it looked like the plane was going to be phased out anyway. While HiFly operates flights for many airlines, there are some examples I would like to point out, because in my opinion, they underline the reason they can exist and what role they play in the aviation industry as a whole. One of the prime examples where HiFly came into play was during the repatriation efforts at the start of the pandemic. In March and April 2020, many governments wanted to offer their citizens a way to return to their home country. However, in most cases, there were not enough commercial options available. To this end, many countries decided to ask their flag carriers and other charter and wet lease airlines to help. HiFly operated many of these flights, and their wide-body fleet, especially the A380, were quite useful here. In the process, they even broke the record for the longest flight with an A340-300. The Airbus flew from Montevideo, Uruguay, non-stop to Melbourne, Australia. The route spent 6,700 nautical miles and took over 16 hours to complete. After the repatriation efforts were finished, demand for the A340 dropped, and they decided to convert the A380 into a freighter aircraft by removing most of the seats. This way, they could now start delivering medical equipment to those in need. Not long after this, as I mentioned before, they phased out the A380. Another reason why airlines might hire HiFly is to allow them to expand quickly without many upfront costs. One such example is Air Senegal. The African airline commenced operations in 2018, and one of the hardest issues for a starting airline is to find the funds to kick off operations. However, by using a charter airline, it gets easier to kick off operations. One can say that it's actually a win-win. The starting airline, like Air Senegal, can start operations at relatively low upfront costs and remains flexible, while the charter airline knows that it will have some steady revenue for the foreseeable future. In the case of Air Senegal, the HiFly plane is actually painted in the Air Senegal livery, so the passengers won't even realize that they are flying with HiFly. The A330neo is used for intercontinental flights between Dakar in Senegal and the United States. The last example has an unpleasant basis. On May 22 of 2020, Pakistan International Airlines flight 8303 crashed. The investigation into the cause of the crash brought forward some serious issues with the licenses of the PIA pilots. To that end, EASA banned PIA from the European airspace for 6 months. This meant that PIA could no longer operate flights to and from Europe. However, in order to keep the operations going, they used HiFly to operate the flights. This was allowed as long as the flights were indeed operated by HiFly and a HiFly crew. So there are countless examples of where HiFly comes into play in the present-day aviation industry. I think they can be seen as the glue that holds some part of the industry afloat. As I mentioned before in the video on the rise and fall of Norwegian, when they had their issues with the 787, they could use an HiFly A380 to at least keep the operations going. While it might not be ideal, it's certainly better than another cancelled flight. Had you ever heard of HiFly, or have you ever been on a HiFly plane? Let me know in the comments below. And what do you think of HiFly? Do you agree with me that they play an integral role in the aviation industry today? Thank you for watching, and please consider subscribing to Let's Talk Aviation.